thanks for joining me in this quick episode. It's going to be a podcast for the MY Bandit channel. We are looking at the season being upon us. The motorcycling season is nearly here. What is the plan? What is going on in the news? We'll have a quick look at the Yamaha news, what's been released, what's coming on at the moment. We'll have a quick look at Kymco in terms of scooters, as well as the range that they offer today, with a quick look at Lexmoto and a quick overview of something interesting that I've seen, AI motorcycles. That's some next level strategy stuff going on there. So sit back, relax, grab yourself a cup of tea, and let's have a look at what's going on in the news today, powered by trustedcreators.org. So thank you for making this possible. Let's go into today's quick overview on the motorcycling world. Yamaha press releases. What's going down here then? Let's have a quick look in the old Yamaha press archives. Looks interesting. World SBK Aragon round to host 2023 Yamaha R7 European Super Finale. Not too enticing. Whenever you show me a scooter, obviously you know on the MI Bandit at the moment we're doing some scooter stuff. Yamaha Moto adopts newly developed eco-friendly recycled polypropylene as a raw material. Does that mean we can't weld our plastic panels together anymore? You see that video I did about plastic panels, step towards employing more carbon neutral raw materials, beginning with ASIN. Okay, that's a little bit boring. I want to show you something that I thought was very interesting. We've heard about AI cars, but nobody's looking at AI motorcycles. On Yamaha, they're actually smashing it out. Look at this. Who needs a rider anymore? Self-riding motorcycles. You want to see it? Let me show you a quick review on what's going down at the moment. This is going to be next level. It's going to blow your mind. Let me show you what I'm talking about here. Okay, here we go. Okay, you ready for it? Let's get rid of this. It is going to be next level. So I was just a bit astonished. So what you've got there is, you can see it's self-balancing. It's a motorcycle. Obviously, it's got those extra bars there for balancing. However, look, it's steering itself. It's got a motor on it. And obviously, Yamaha had to do it. They've got a rider on there just to show what's going on. However, what? So in what circumstance would you want it to be riderless? You want to sit as a pillion on your own bike? Or is it that you can park it somewhere and it comes to you? Would you buy a self-riding motorcycle? That is next level. I think it's a great achievement. So good job. Well done, well done. Oh yeah, self-riding is all that you're going. If you're listening on the podcast, you need to come over to the actual video version of this to see this on screen. I'm showing you that. Oh, look, it reverses. Oh, it rolled back a little bit and I thought it was going to reverse. That would have been an interesting adaptation of it. AI motorcycling is where it's at, people. AI. No, self-drive. Motorcycles. Yamaha. Rev your heart. Yup. So let's just deep dive in that. What is that all about? Controlling drive and steering forces for rider machine unity and peace of mind for all motorcyclists. Okay, in what way? Last year, Yamaha Moto announced its safety vision, which aims to create a world free of accidents together with with our customers. The three pillars of our the rider aid to enhance stability with starts and at low speeds. Okay, so starting up, it'll give you like a little bit of help. If you're going through traffic, low speeds, it might give you like a bit of a balancing so you don't fall off your bike. Okay, that is some slow control, but I like the look of the bike. But I'm not sure about that extra little bit of hang off on the bottom. What do you reckon? Is this something that you think you would get as like a optional extra? The Translap always gets good opinions. So Honda XL 750 Translap is basically like a Twin Africa kind of situation, isn't it? Like a nice go anywhere adventure type. So the new model around town or around the world. Oh, Mondo, holy mono. The old ones weren't all that, but the new one, this one looks quite fancy. What do you reckon? Is that on your list of bikes? Is that the type of bikes you're looking for? I'll give you an idea about introduction. What we're saying, the original Transalp introduced in 1986 with the 583 V-twin engine is something of a legend, as a testament to the sheer quality of its build and timelessness of its design. Many can still be seen on Europe's roads today. Yeah, you can get a nice old one very cheap. Would you get a new one though? I don't know, it's an interesting idea. Probably, maybe, you let me know. Love to hear from you. So Honda, that is obviously, we've done a look at Yamaha there, we're looking at AI, Honda's looking at Transalps. Have they added anything new to it? There probably, there's loads of specs on there. I'm not going to go through all that information for you, but yeah. So I think it's important that we looked at a scooter, being, you know, recently we're doing some scooter renovations. So what do you think of the Honda Forza range? It's not like the new one, it's been around for a while. 125cc, I reckon it looks like, you know, pretty decent. There's a few options in it. You've got like the Forza 125, they've got the bigger brothers of them as well. So Honda's premium sports GT Forza 125 scooter gains an elegant refined style refresh, a redesigned dash and new special editions options for 23. Standard specifications include HSTC electric screen, adjustable USB type C socket. Holy moly mate, some phones don't come in those at the moment. Actually no, yeah they do, but they're not as good. I do like the look of that, you know. I'm a bit partial to like a good scooter, you know. Who needs a motorbike when you can have a scooter that does everything? Would you get a scooter, would you get a motorbike? Let me know. So that was one, but I did see there's another one they had in there. Have I got that up? Let me bring up the other one. I like that one as well. It's always good when there's like new awards coming out and stuff. So what's been going on at the moment? Did you know Honda triumphs again at Red Dot Design Awards? So they've got Red Dot Designs on a few of their rides. So you see the Transalps there. They've got one on their motorcycle range and a few on their cars. What is the Red Dot Design Award? It's actually quite a big thing. It's like when you, let me have a look and show you. The Red Dot Award brand is a communications design recognizing the brand's creative works of the year. So it's been around for a while. It's going to be a German international design prize awarded by Red Dot, and it's been there for like since 1955. So well done Honda, you guys are renovating in design, so obviously there's some type of guidelines that they work with. It was pursued by companies and design studios as a credible endorsement of their design excellence. Nice job, well done Honda, doing it, smashing it. That's how we're rolling. Okay, what else we got? They'll sneak in from the back when you're not looking. They'll come up with like a new range of stuff. So Kymco, you'll see some of their bikes are looking quite snazzy. Again, this is like not the latest greatest range of bikes, however they've actually got a nice sneaky lineup of I think cool is the word. They're looking at electric as well, so there's a few options there for like scooters, motorcycles. They've done some redesign on their overall appearance. Would you get a Kymco though? That is the actual option. Sensation of sound, so they're going to sound a bit more electrified. Versatility of modes, okay, it does look quite nice from the top down view. But originally they were like Chinese scooters, not everybody liked them, but over time I reckon they're going to get to a point where, you know, you won't be able to tell the difference in terms of what they're offering. So on the website you've got like a range of scooters and motorcycles. So all the way up to 550 maxi scooters. You got like sports ranges in there. So what do you think? It'd be interesting what they come up with on these, I think. Yep, there has been some new news. Have you seen the new bikes that Triumph have been trying to test out? So it's basically along the lines of Triumph motocross bike tested, and they've had some footage. It's always like taken with a potato camera, but you can see they're either testing to see what's going on, they're probably releasing something. A video has appeared of the much anticipated Triumph motocross bike, of which finally have our first low quality look. You might as well, you know, be any bike just wrapped in black. Oh okay, can I see it? Oh, it's a photo. I thought there'd be a video. This is on Wiser Down. Oh wait a minute, check out the video below. Oh yeah, come on. Oh, that sounds nice. Oh my days, holy, oh that was too much. Is that it? Come on, have we got another view? Oh yeah, okay. Nah, that's that's a bit bait. Someone's recorded that. That's not like a press capture, is it? That sounds really nice though. Triumph Racing Signs starts. Oh, 2024. Oh, but I don't know. Do you think they are like Triumph? When you think of Triumph, do you think of motocross? Maybe there's a bit of heritage history there from where they're originally starting, but recently I've just considered them as like old school type looking bikes. But then again, they've got Triumph Tiger, they've got all that range of bikes which are, they've got a good hold in the market, so there's no reason why they can't do a motocross. What do you reckon? It'll be interesting, see what happens. It's only fair, we had a quick look at the old Lexmoto guys, what's going on over there. They're nice, like 125 ranges they originally did. On their YouTube channel, it's have they got any new updates? About 2 weeks ago, Lexmoto SRT 125 ride out the ideal city scooter. Oh, definitely check that out. Let's have a look. Let's have a quick little sneak peek. I'll make sure to check out their channel. They've got a nice couple of reviews, like more real life reviews these days. Looks like a cub from this angle. But if you're going out and about, I've got like a little walk around of it. Kimco and Lexmoto is kind of like their arena, but they've got a nice new city scooter 125cc SRT. Did he start with a walk around? Did I miss it? Oh, here we go. Okay, so it looks like the first scooter I ever rode, like the Yamaha Aero, was it, that I used to get? So it's like, this is very scootery, isn't it? I'm used to more of, oh, I like that nice little transition. Good job there, Lexmoto motorcycles. Okay, not bad. Holding it, wrapping it. Episode with a nice quick look at what's going on over on MCN. So we'll round this episode off today. Yamaha Tracer 9 GT 2023 on. Okay, now look, everybody's getting these types of bikes. They're sports kind of, sports tourer. I like them, you know, because it's like a do-it-all. You can get a good speed out of them. If you want to go far distance, you've got luggage, and then they look quite mean. It reminds me of the Yamaha Phasers, kind of, you know, the front of it, how it is like a bit higher and a bit more toury. Okay, what they're saying on this then? Highlights classic leading spec, yeah, world's first radar linked unified braking system, was at a glance power 117 bhp, mate. Seat height quite tall, I'm quite a short ass, so medium 32 inch. Price 14 grand, mate. Would you pay 14 grand? Overall rating 4 out of 5. The 23 year advanced. Oh, come on now, it looks like the MTO range, you know, MT9 and MT10, and like a bit more transformery. Reliability and build, come on, it's Yamaha, we should be good there, I think. Yeah, that's what you want, mate. Oh yeah, hopefully you found this episode interesting. Just looked at what's going on recently in the news, and you know what's going on in the motorcycling world. We're nearly amongst it. Are you getting a new bike? What bike are you going to be getting? I'll see you on the next episode. See you there.